Welcome back to another video on graph theory. Previously, we have done the pictorial representations of graph. Now, to analyze large graphs, there are alternative representations available. Here, I'll describe how to represent a graph using matrices. There are different kinds of matrix representations available. Here, I'll concentrate on adjacency matrix and incidence matrix of a graph. So, let us start with adjacency matrix. So firstly, I'll take a simple undirected graph with n number of vertices, v1, v2, vn. So for this kinds of graph, the adjacency matrix is defined as a matrix of order n cross n whose entries are given by aij, which is equal to 1 if the vertices vi and vj are adjacent. That means there is an edge connecting vi, vj, and otherwise it is 0. So in this matrix, each row is associated with a fixed vertex. For example, if we take this graph G, so here we have V1, V2, V3. These are the vertices. So the matrix will be a matrix of order 3. So here we'll get V1, V2, V3. These are the vertices. This is a matrix of order 3, 3 cross 3, and each row is associated with a vertex. Each column is associated with a vertex. So the first row is associated with V1, second row is with V2, and third row is with V3. Similarly, the first column corresponds to V1, second corresponds to V2, and third one corresponds to V3. So this is the structure. Now, what are the entries? So it is written, this is simple undirected graph. That means the graph does not contain any self loop or parallel edges, and it is undirected. That means if there is an edge connecting vi, vj, that also can be represented by vj, vi, because here we have unordered pair of vertices. So every edge in this graph is associated with unordered pair of vertices. So let us try to write the entries. So first it is V1, V1. So this is a simple graph, so we don't have any self loop. So it is 0. V1 is not associated with V1, adjacent with V1. But V1 is adjacent to V2 and V3. So here we'll get 1. Here also we'll get 1. Secondly, the position of V2. So here we have V2. V2 is adjacent to V1 and V3. So it is 1. Is 1, but here we'll get 0 because we don't have any self loop at the point V2. Similarly, V3 is adjacent to V1 and V3 is adjacent to V2. So here we have 1. So this is the adjacency matrix of the given graph G. And here we have some observations. So here we have considered a simple undirected graph. So for a simple undirected graph, the matrix, adjacency matrix, is always symmetric. That is the first observation. That is, Aij is equal to Aji. So if we take, so suppose this is our matrix A. So if you take A transpose, here we'll see A is equal to A transpose. So adjacency matrix of a simple undirected graph is always symmetric. Secondly, since this is a simple graph, so we don't have any self loop, so the diagonal entries are always 0. So diagonal entries Aii is always 0 for all I. Now the third point, what about the degrees of the vertices? So what is called degree of a vertex Vi? The number of edges incident with the vertex determines the degree of that vertex. So here, if we consider V1, the degree of V1 is 2. It is associated with, it is incident with 2 edges. So here, if you look at the row corresponding to V1, we'll see there are 2 ones. So the number of ones present in the ith row is equal to the degree of the vertex vi. Similarly, the number of ones present in the ith column also determines the degree of the vertex. So for example, if we consider v1, the degree of v1 is 2. So 2 ones are present over here in the first column. Similarly, on the first row, we have 2 ones present. So the degrees can also be determined from the adjacency matrices. So these are the observations we have for simple undirected graphs. Next, let us go to a pseudograph. That means a graph which contains both self-loop and parallel edges. So for this kinds of graph, we'll define our adjacency matrix as n cross n matrix if we have n number of vertices, where the entries are given by aij, that is equal to the number of edges incident with the vertices vi and vj, and it is zero otherwise. So it would be better if we look at the example and try to understand the definition. So say this is our graph G2. So here also each row is corresponding to a vertex. So first let us label the vertices. So here we have 4 vertices, V1, V2, V3 and V4. So V1, V2, V3, V4. So this is a matrix of order 4 cross 4. Now, so here we have about V1. So V1, at V1, we have a self loop. So considering self loop as 1, so a self loop at the vertex VI, a self loop at VI corresponds to AII is equal to 1. So here we have 1. After that, V1 to V2, there is only one edge. So it is 1. Then V1 to V3, we have only one edge. It is 1. And between V1 and V4, we don't have any edge. So it is 0. Next. Next, regarding V2. So V2 is adjacent to V1. There is only one edge connecting V2 and V1. So it is 1. Then at V2, we don't have any self loop. So V2 is 0. Then V2 to V3 is 0. There is no edge between V2 and V3. And V2 to V4 is 1. After that, V3 to V1 is also 1. V3 to V2 is 0. We don't have any loop at the point V3. So it is 0, V3. Then regarding V3 and V4, here we can see how many edges are present. So there are 3 parallel edges connecting V3 and V4. So here we'll write 3. So V3, V4 is 3 because it is the number of edges incident with VI and VJ. So 3 edges are there who are incident with V3 and V4. Next, regarding V4, so V4 to V1 is 0. Then V4, V2 is 1. V4, V3 is further 3 because there are 3 edges connecting V4, V3 and V4, V4 is 0. So this is how we construct the adjacency matrix of a pseudograph. Pseudograph means where we both have parallel edges and self loops. So here we have the properties. So what are the properties we are getting? So observation 1, pseudograph, the adjacency matrix of pseudograph is also symmetric. So here we have 1, 2 position is 1, 2, 1 position is also 1, 1, 3 position is 1, 3, 1 position is also 1, and so on. So for pseudograph, A is equal to A transpose. That means A is symmetric. Now the second point, since this is a pseudograph, the diagonal entries are not necessarily always zero, because here we may have some self loops. So let us construct another adjacency matrix of a pseudo graph. Say so this is the graph V1, V2, V3, and V4. So first we label the vertices. So V1, V2, V3, and V4. So we have a self loop over here. So this should be a matrix of order 4, 4 cross 4. V1, V2, V3, and V4. There are 4 vertices. So at the point V1, we don't have any self loop. Then V1, between V1 and V2, there are 2 edges. So it is 2. Then V2, V1, between V2 and V1, there are also 2 edges. So it is also 2. Then at V2, we don't have any self loop. So V2 is 0. Then regarding V2 and V3, so V2 and V3 are connected by 1 edge. So 1. V1 is not connected to V3. So it is 0. V1 is connected to V4 by 1 edge, so it is 1. Next, V2, V4. So there is no edge connecting V2, V4, so it is 0. Then V3, V1 is 0. V3, V2 is 1. Then V3, V4 is 2. And V3 is 0, because there is no self loop at the point V3. Then V4, so V4, V1 is connected by 1 edge. Then V4 to V2 is 0. V2, V4 is also 0. Then V4, V3 is 2. And V4, V4 is 1. So this is the adjacency matrix of the pseudo graph. Next, we'll consider a die graph with n number of vertices V1, V2, Vn. So this is a die graph. That means each edge is associated with an ordered pair of vertices. That means here, if there is an edge connecting Vi, Vj, which is not equal to Vj, Vi. That is the first point. Now, for this kinds of graph, we define adjacency matrix as a matrix of order n cross n, whose entries are given by it is 1 if there is a directed edge from Vi to Vj. So this is the important point, and 0 otherwise. So let us try to construct the adjacency matrix of this graph. Say this is G3. So this to be G4. So this is the graph G4. So here also we have V1, V2, V3, V4, V5. There are 5 vertices. So this would be a matrix of order 5. Now, regarding V1. So there is a directed edge from V1 to V2. So V1, V2 is an edge. So here we can write 1. V1, V1 is 0. Then V1 to V3, there is no directed edge. So 0. From V1 to V4, it is 0, because the direction is from V4 to V1, not from V1 to V4. And regarding V1 to V5, we don't have any edge, so it is 0. Secondly, if you look at V2, so from V2, there is a directed edge from V2 to V3 only. So from V2 to V3, there is a directed edge, and there is no other directed edge from the rest of the vertices. So we can put zeros over there. Next, regarding V3. So from V3, there is directed edge to V1 and to V4. So V3 to V1 and V3 to V4. And the rest of the entries are zeros. Next, V4. So from V4, only one directed edge is there towards V1. So it is 1. Then V4 to V1, and then all the other entries are zeros in this row. And V5, from V5, there is only V5 to V2. The rest of the entries are zeros. So this is how we construct adjacency matrix of a diagraph. So here we have some observations. So the first observation is the adjacency matrix of a diagraph, say A, is not necessarily symmetric. Second point, the number of ones present in a row that represent the out degree of a vertex. So how many edges are directed from V1, are starting from a vertex V1, is called the out degree of a vertex. So here we can see the out degree of V1 is only 1. And in degree, that means how many edges are ending at the point V1 is called the in degree of a vertex. What is the in degree of V1? Here we can see it is 2. So if we look at the row corresponding to 1, we'll see there is only 1 present in the first row. So the number of ones present in a particular row in ith row is equal to in degree, out degree of the vertex vi, is the out degree of the vertex vi. And if we consider the column, corresponding column of v1, here we'll see it is 2. 2 ones are present over there. So the number of ones present in ith column is equal to the in degree of the vertex vi, that is t minus of vi. Now these kinds of questions are asked. Draw the graphs from the adjacency matrices. That means adjacency matrices are given, so from which we need to draw the graph. So for the first one, let us first label the rows. So let V1, V2, V3 and V4. These are the four vertices and these are the four vertices over here. So firstly, we can see the matrix is symmetric about the principal diagonal. So our first observation is our graph is going to be undirected graph. So let us first take the vertices, say V1, V2, V3 and V4. So this is adjacency matrix which represents the relations of vertices. So V1, V1, this position is 0. So that means there is no self loop at V1. Next, V1 is adjacent to V2 and V4. So there is an edge connecting V1, V2 and V1, V4. After that, if you consider V2, now V2 is adjacent to V1 and V3. So V2 is adjacent to V1 and V2 is adjacent to V3. Next, V3. V3 is adjacent to V2 and V4. V3 is adjacent to V2 and V3 is adjacent to V4. So what about V4? Here we can see V4 is adjacent to V1. We have already done this. And V4 is adjacent to V3. And there is no self loop present over here. So this is the corresponding graph G1. Now let us go into the second one. So here we can see, so it is 1, 0, 1, 1. So 1, 3 position is not same as 3, 1 position. So this is not undirected graph. So there is a possibility of getting a digraph. So first let us label the vertices V1, V2, V3, V4. and V1, V2, V3, V4. So V1, V2, V3, and V4. So V1 is equal to 1. That means there is a self loop present over here. After that, V1 is adjacent to V3 and V1 is adjacent to V4. But V3 is not adjacent to V1. V3 is not adjacent to any other vertex except 4. So here we can conclude that this graph is going to be a digraph. So V1 to V3, there is a directed edge. So from V1 to V3, we have a directed edge. Next, from V1 to V4, we have another directed edge. From V1 to V4. Next, if we consider V2 is connected. So there is a self loop. Next, V2 to V3, there is directed edge from V2 to V3. After that, V3 to V4, there is another directed edge. After that, V4, so from V4 to V1, so from V4 to V1, there is a directed edge. Then V4 to V2, we have another directed edge. So this is the graph G2 corresponding to our second adjacency matrix, which is a digraph. Next, we'll go into incidence matrix. So let us first try to write incidence matrix of undirected graph. A GV undirected graph with n number of vertices, V1, V2, Vn, and m number of edges, say U1, E2, EM. Then the incidence matrix of the graph G denoted by IG is defined as a matrix of order n cross m. So whenever we have n number of vertices and m number of edges, the incidence matrix will be a matrix of order n cross m, where each row corresponds to a particular vertex and each column corresponds to a particular edge. And the entries are given by Aij, which is equal to 1, if the jth edge is incident with the ith vertex Vi and 0 otherwise. So let us try to write the incidence matrix of this graph G, then it will be very clear. So first we'll denote the rows by vertices. So here we have A, B, C, D, E, and F. These are the vertices present over here. And here we have 7 edges, E1, E2, E3, E4, E5, E6, and E7. So we have 7 edges. So this is a matrix of order 6 cross 7. Now we need to write the entries. So the edge E1 is incident with the vertices A and B. So AE1 is 1 and E1B is also 1. And E1 is not incident with the other vertices. So these are all zeros. Next, regarding E2, the edge E2 is incident with A and E. So it is 1, AE2 is 1 and EE2 is 1. All the other entries are zeros. Next, E3 is incident with A and C. So A and C, the other entries are zeros in this column. Then E4, the edge E4 is an edge connecting B and C. So B and C, the other entries are zeros. Then E5 is incident with C and E. C and E. The other positions are zeros. And E6 also connects C and E. C and E. And E7 is an edge connecting D and C. So C and D, these positions are 1. The rest of the entries are zeros in this column. So this is the incidence matrix of the Krafcic according to the definition. So here we have certain observations. The first observation is, the matrix must be a matrix of order n cross m. Secondly, each column of IG has exactly 2 unit entries because every edge connects 2 vertices. So each column contains 2 unit entries. Now, secondly, a row with all zeros corresponds to an isolated vertex. So here, if we consider the last row, here the vertex F is isolated vertex because it is not incident with some edge or it is not adjacent to some other vertices. So F is isolated vertex, and from here also we can see the vertex F is not incident with any one of these edges. So a row with all zeros corresponds to an isolated vertex. Third important point. So here we have a pendant vertex. What is pendant vertex? Which is incident with only one edge or which is adjacent to only one vertex is called a pendant vertex. Here D is a pendant vertex. And here we can see the row corresponding to the pendant vertex contains only one unit element. So a row with single unit entry, a row with single unit entry corresponds to a pendant vertex. Now the fourth point regarding the degree of a vertex. So degree of a vertex is equal to the number of ones in the row of the vertex. So if you look at the row, so here we can see the row corresponding to the vertex A contains 3 ones. And here we can see the vertex A is incident with 3 edges, E1, E2, E3. So the degree of the vertex A is 3. So the degree of a vertex is equal to the number of ones present in the corresponding row of the incidence matrix. Next, let us see how to write incidence matrix of a digraph. Let G be a digraph with no self loops, having n number of vertices, say v1, v2, vn, and m number of edges, say e1, e2, em. So for this die graph, the incidence matrix is defined to be a matrix of order n cross m. So whenever we have n number of vertices and m number of edges, the matrix is a matrix of order n cross m. Then regarding the entries, the elements are given by aij, which is equal to 1 if the jth edge ej is incident out of the vertex vi. It is minus 1 if ej is incident into the vertex vi, and 0 otherwise. That means if there is no edge connecting the vertex vi to some other vertex. So for example, let us take this graph. So here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 vertices. Each row is associated with a particular vertex here. So we have 4 rows corresponding to the vertices A, B, C, D. And here we have 6 edges, E1, E2, E3, E4, E5, and E6. So this is a matrix of order 4 cross 6. Now regarding the entries, so here we can see the edge E1 is incident out of the vertex A, so it is 1. Next E2 is incident out of the vertex A, the direction is from A towards B, so it is 1. Then E3, so E3 is incident out of the vertex A. Next E4, there is no connection of E4 and A, so it is 0. Then E5, so we have 0 over here because E5 is not connected to A. Then E6, if we consider E6, so E6 incident into the vertex A, so it is minus of 1. After that, regarding V, so E1 is incident into the vertex V, so it is minus 1. Then E2 is also incident into the vertex B, so it is minus 1. E3, so there is no edge. That means there is no connection between B and E3. The edge E3 is not connected to B, so it is 0. Then E4 is incident out of the vertex B, so it is plus 1. And E5, it is also 0. And E6, this is also 0. After that, regarding C, so E3 is incident into the vertex C, so it is minus 1. And E5 is incident out of the vertex C, so it is plus 1. Rest of the entries are zeros. Next, D. So from D, we have E6, which is incident out of D, so it is plus 1. Then E4 is incident into D, so minus 1. E5 is also incident into D, so minus 1. And rest of the entries are zeros. So this is our required incidence matrix of a die graph. So the entries of incidence matrix of a die graph are 0, 1 or minus 1. Let us try to draw the graph whose corresponding incidence matrix is given by this. So let us first label the vertices. So let V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, V6. These are the vertices. And the name of the edges be E1, E2, E3, E4 and E5. So we have 6 vertices, say V1, V2, V3, V4 and V5 and V6. So V1, V2, V3, V4, V5 and V6. These are the vertices. And next we'll go on connecting the edges. Now from the entries we can see the corresponding graph is going to be a die graph because the entries are 1, minus 1 and 0. The first one is E1. So E1 is an edge between V2 and V4. Because if you consider the column, okay, so there are 2 vertices, V2 and V4. They are incident with E1. So V2 is incident. So E1 is incident into V2. because of minus one entry. So between V2 and V4, there is an edge, and E1 is incident into V2, and V4, regarding V4, E1 incident out of V4. So this is the one, this is the direction. Next, regarding E2. E2 is between V2 and V5. So V2 and V5. Now there is E2. So V2, E2 is incident out of V2. And V5, E2 is incident into V5. Next, E3. If you consider E3. So E3 connects V1 and V6. So between V1 and V6, we have E3. Now E3, V1, E3. So E3, incident out of the vertex V1. Next, E4. E4 is between V1 and V6. So we have another edge between V1 and V6, which is given by E4. And in this case, E4 incident into V1. The direction is in this direction. Next, E5. E5 connects V1 and V4. V1 and V4. E5 is incident out of V1. So this is the direction we have, E5. So this is our required graph, and here we can see V3 is isolated vertex. V3 is isolated. So corresponding to V3, the row does not contain any element like 1 or minus 1. That means V3 is isolated vertex, which is not connected to any other vertex. So this is the required diagram. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, then please like and subscribe my channel.